Hi there guys and welcome back to the Tower Tech, I'm Michael C. This episode is going to focus on why to water cool and how to water cool. It's time to go to Geek School! There's a couple of scientific principles that we need to talk about. I know, we're not at school, but they are important and they'll help you understand why a water cooling loop is much more efficient than an air cooling system. Specifically, those laws are conservation of energy and transfer of heat, conduction, convection and radiation, all of which are used in a water cooling loop. Let's go to the geek board and I'll explain them. The law of the conservation of energy states that energy cannot be created or destroyed. It can only be converted from one form into another. It can also be transferred from one object to another. One form of this is called the transfer of heat. Heat will normally transfer from a high temperature source to a low temperature source, and it will continue to do this until both objects have equalized in temperature. This is how water cooling works. Let me demonstrate. We have a heat source. The heat source is a fire. Onto the fire we place a metal pan. That's a solid. Heat is transferred from the fire through the metal pan through the process of conduction. That's atoms within the pan bouncing together, causing friction. Inside the pan is water. Heat is transferred from the metal pan into the water. Warm water at the bottom of the pan rises to the top and is replaced down below by cold water. It creates a flow. This is called convection. As heat rises to the top of the water, it causes the air atoms at its surface to vibrate and it radiates that temperature out into the atmosphere. Okay, Michael, fine. The physics stuff's great. How does that apply to water cooling? Well, think of the CPU as the fire source. It generates heat. Your water block is your pan. That's going to conduct the heat away from the CPU up into the water. So here's your water block. It sits on top of the CPU, much like a normal air cooling heat sink, and attached with thermal paste. This is the reservoir, holds water, and at the bottom of this particular reservoir is a pump. The pump pumps fluid up through the tubing, creating our convection current. There's not enough fluid in the system, it needs some help. It gets hot within the CPU block, it then moves up another tube. This is called a loop. It then moves across the radiator at the top of the system. It causes fins in the radiator to get hot and then radiates that temperature out into the atmosphere. Okay, Michael, so what about the GPUs? Exact same principle applies. Again, there's another reservoir, there's tubing, you have a block that goes on the GPU, water passes over some fins inside the block, water gets hot, and in the instance of this system, goes down into a radiator down here in the bottom. I should say again at this point, I said the same thing in my first video, this build is inspired by Jay's Two Cents. There's a link to his channel down in the description. Do go check it out. It's got some fabulous videos on how to build a PC like this. So why is water better through conductivity than air? Well, as a material, if we define water and we put it on a graph, and we compare that to air, looking at the ratio of conductivity being a measure of watts per meter per Kelvin. Water has a conductivity of 0.6. Air has a conductivity of 0.025. Water is significantly more conductive than air. Lots of theory, thanks very much for that. You still haven't taught me how I'm gonna build a computer like this. Okay. If you wanna learn how to do that, you're gonna have to check in to the next episode of Geek School. See you in the next video.